The Oracle Television Network wishes you a happy Valentine's Day. Celebrate love in God's way.
So tell us your names.
Rhoda Kea.
Rhoda, how are you today?
I'm blessed.
Tell me one thing. What is your opinion concerning Valentine's Day?
Oh my God, Valentine's. Valentine's should not be just as people understand Valentine's is the day of love, but for me, it shouldn't be necessarily on the 14th of February. Every day is a day of love. God is love. God does not love you on a specific day or on a specific time. And as Christians and as believers, we are supposed to love each other, one another. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, January to December, no limited time. No specific day, no specific month. Love is just love. So I don't take Valentine's so seriously. All I just need to say is love should be unconditional. No matter the time of the day, no matter the month of the year, love should just flow forever.
So should it be confined only to the couples or?
No, everybody. That's what I'm saying. Love is not supposed to be just on a specific day. Tunazenda tunasaidia watoto kwa barabara, go to the underprivileged, the homeless, even your own neighbor. Hata watu kwa kanisa. I mean, love is to be shared in one accord. Agape love. Actually, me, I'm preaching agape love, not Valentine's love. Yes, to everybody. Love is open for everyone. Yes, so don't restrict it just for couples. Yes.
Thank you so much.
Tunafurahia sana. Amen.
So nitaenda tupatie maoni yako wewe kama mzazi kuhusu Valentine's Day na upatie vijana wadogo ushauri.
Okay, Valentine ni ile hali ya kuishi katika upendo walioana. Wale ambao wanapendana kama bwana na mume. Uaminifu unatakikana. Trust. Ukibreak trust yako, ukiwa kama bwana au uwe ni bibi, Valentine haiwezi kuwa na maana. Kwa hivyo ni vizuri kuwa na amani na kuwa na kuaminiana, kule kuelewana na kufahamiana. Unakaa kama Kristo, ukiwa unaamini Yesu, nasema ukae katika hiyo hali. Amen.
Lakini vijana wadogo pia wanasherekea na wasichana wadogo. Na umeongea kuhusu wale watu ambao wameoana. Ungependa kuambia je, wamepotoka njiani ama wako sawa?
Okay, kama vile unajua vijana ndio wazazi wa kesho. Na wanaposherehekea, wanasherehekea wakijua kwa imani siku moja watakuwa wazazi. Wakati mmoja watakuwa na, kama bwana na mke. Kwa hivyo kusherehekea kwa walio wasiooana pia sio mbaya, si makosa. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah.
Labda mama na yeye atuambie ni wapi hawafai kupita hao vijana wasichana. Ni wapi hawafai kupita?
Vile ningesema wanatakiwa waangalie uaminifu, na uaminifu ni kusema ya kwamba wanatakiwa waangalie the holiness. Hata kama kuna Valentine, sio kusema dhambi iwe katika Valentine, wanatakiwa waangalie holiness and righteousness. Yes.
So nyinyi huwa mnasherehekea Valentine's?
Tunasherehekea. Mm-hmm. Kama mwana na bibi. Okay. Yeah. Asante. Na tunapendana. Uh-huh. Amen.
So ungependa kuambia couples wengine pia ambao wameoana kwa muda kama nyinyi pia wazidi kusherehekea?
Nataka kuwauliza ya kwamba waweze kukumbuka ya kwamba ni mapenzi ambayo yameweka pamoja. Kwa hivyo wanapochagua siku kama hii ya Valentine kusherehekea na kufurahia ni muhimu sana. Wanaweza kuitenga kama siku ya maana. Asante.
This is Joy Bulimu.
So I want to ask you about Valentine's. What is your perception on Valentine's? Maybe as a Christian, how do you think about Valentine's?
Basically growing up, I have always known that Valentine's is for people, a couple or something, or people who are dating. But as I've grown up in Christianity, is a time to also love yourself and maybe appreciate self-love and appreciate singlehood as well, yes.
So according to you, Christians should also celebrate Valentine's?
Yes, they should also celebrate Valentine's. And it doesn't have to be people from the opposite sex. It can also be a lady and a lady, a guy and a guy appreciating each other, yes.
What about this notion of people thinking that that is a day to go and go out and do immorality and engage in other bad things, in drinking and immorality? What do you think about that?
I think at the end of the day, people have choices. It depends how you have been brought up. But for me, I would encourage people. It's also fun to come in church. It is also fun. You can also know people and have fun with people in church. Yes.
Do you normally celebrate Valentine's?
Yes, I do.
Which one in particular maybe was peculiar?
Last year, I celebrated with my girlfriends back in Nairobi, in campus. And one thing that stood out for me, it doesn't have to be a person from the opposite sex. You can get together as friends and go and have fun and get people in church and maybe go and have fun, yes. And it doesn't have to be on Valentine's Day that love is always preached. It should always go throughout the year. Yes.
Do you think the government should make this a public holiday?
Not really. I don't know. Maybe. I don't know.
How about gazetting it so that it is recognized by the law?
For me, it's not really important because love should always flow throughout the year. It doesn't have to be a specific day. Yes.
Valentine, mimi naona kama ni watu wapenda nao, kuonesha upendo kwa watu ambao unapenda. Maybe unaweza amboka kutembelea hata children's homes, tembelee mamako, mzazi, mke wako, mnulie zawadi hata kama ni maua, kitu kama hiyo. Ni siku ambao unafaa kuspend na your family ama watu ambao wanaonekana kama wajionesha upendo kwa siku nyingi. Na Valentine inakuwa ni kila siku kwa ambao wameokoka.
Kwa hivyo idea watu ya kwamba Valentine ni siku ya watu kufanya anasa, kunywa pombe na kufanya mambo ya dhambi, wewe kwa upande wako unasema ni jambo la Kikristo ambao tunafaa kusherehekea hata watu ambao wameokoka.
Ya, hiyo mambo ya kuenda kufanya anasa na ati kusema kuenda kufanya usharati na yale mambo mengine, hiyo si mambo ya kiungu, hiyo ni mambo ya kidunia na ni uongo wa shetani. Kwa watu ambao wameokoka na wanamjua Mungu, si kufanya vitu kama hizo. Kitu ya kwanza ni kushukuru Mungu. Valentine ni watu wanaokoka iko kila siku. Siku wa siku moja. Ni kumshukuru Mungu na kuonesha upendo kuextend kwa watu ambao wanaonekana kama hawajapendwa. Hata kwenye hao dhambi na kuonesha kwa Kristo kuna upendo. Na kuonesha kusherekea opposite na wenye wanasherekea hao. Yeah.
So wewe unasherekea Valentine's?
Yeah, mimi ndasherekea Valentine na mke wangu hapa na watoto wangu hapa. Mimi mwenyewe ndo niko na surprise yao.
Asante sana. Na mbarikie sana.
Amen.
Today's show, the Valentine show. Well, each year we celebrate Valentine, but do we really know what Valentine is all about? Is it about the red roses? Is it about chocolate? Is it about candies? Is it about red dress code? Something to think about. why don't we have a dress code for Christmas? Well, we do have. Some will put on red and green and make it more like there is snow, so it's some snowy kind of an affair, like white Christmas. But then, in every celebration, there's always a reason for the celebration. Now, Valentine is one of the celebrations or events that has really, really taken the market. Go to the shops today, go to the store, you see flowers all over the place. Someone who has never received a rose will receive it on Valentine. I even had someone say, don't bring roses to my grave, bring them on Valentine's when I'm alive. Every other day for me is a Valentine. Where does this history come from? Well, we can travel back to history. Many, many years back, there was a king, and he was a Roman king. But there was an army in those days, and they didn't want the young men to get married. Why? Because if they were married and they were in the army, they didn't fight so well for fear of what would befall their families if they died. So enters Saint Valentine, who was a priest. Now, Saint Valentine introduced Valentine because he came with a different law. He came and said that we can marry them when they are young and still have a continuity. We can still have them getting married and enjoying a love because they had the Christian belief, they had the Christian faith, but somehow they were tied to their vows when they went into the army. And so he introduced it against the wishes of the ruler of the day. Now, this got him into trouble. He was jailed just because of marrying them against the wishes of the king. So while he was still in jail, one of the persons that was taking care of his case or his the proceedings had a daughter who was unwell. And then he ended up praying for that girl, and the girl got healed. So he writes a letter to that girl, and he says, from your Valentine. Now, he was calling his name Valentine, and everybody thought, oh, your Valentine means your love. And that's how Valentine's Day came into being. He ended up dead, but we still have the Valentine thing coming in. Now, Valentine is not a worldly kind of a celebration. It's supposed to be celebrated God's way, because the Bible says in 1 John 4:7-8, God is the author of love. Anyone who doesn't love is not born of God. Now, let's now come now to the real love. You know, we have agape love, we have the parents' love, and we now have the eros love, which we are now celebrating. Should we celebrate Valentine on 14th of February only? No. Reasons being, every day should be a Valentine. You cannot wait for one day and then you express your love on one day. You cannot just waiting for a one day in a year just to celebrate someone you love, to celebrate someone you live with, or to celebrate someone you want to spend your eternity with. Valentine should not just be a day's every day, but it should be every moment. Now, this is what the Bible says. In the book of Ephesians, chapter number 5, the Bible says, wives, be in subjection unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ also is the head of the church, being himself the savior of the body. But as the church is subject to Christ, so let the wives also be to their husbands in everything. I read somewhere where someone said that Valentine is there to make the single people feel bad. No, that's not the case. Because if you cannot love yourself, then how can you enjoy love from someone else? How can you love others if you cannot have self-love? The Bible says, love your neighbor as you love yourself. Don't wait to get married for you to enjoy love. You can enjoy love even when you're single. And we know there's definition of love that I'm going to describe, which the Bible is very, very particular about. Now, when the Bible talks about wives being in subjection, why are wives not taught to love their husbands? Why are wives not taught to love? Because for a woman, loving is automatic. They don't need to be taught to love. Women have it's in them, it's in us. We can love naturally. We don't need a lot to love, but we can really love. You can imagine someone just getting married, they leave their father's home, they go get married, they change their name just in the name of love. It is not hard for women to love. But then submission is where now it gets it hard. Now, submission is not oppression. Submission is not slavery. Most people believe that submission is supposed to be an act where now the woman is oppressed or the woman is feels lesser because she's second. Submission doesn't mean that you're second. In fact, it is not even undermining the wife. Now, I have seen women submit to people who are not their husband. We were not taught to submit to every man. Submission was meant for the husband. I've gone to places where men thought that because I'm a woman, I'm supposed to submit to them. I tell them, no, I'm not supposed to submit to every man, because the Bible is very clear that I should submit to my husband. So it is not a sign of weakness. It is not a sign of struggling. It's not a sign of showing that you are lesser. No. In fact, submission is a sign that you are stronger, because you submit to someone's vision, who is the vision bearer in the family, and then you proceed to making the vision greater, even in the place of submission. What does the Bible continue to say in Ephesians chapter number 25? I'll read. This is a charge to men. In fact, when you look at Ephesians, most of the charge is to men. I think one of the reasons why the charge is more unto men is because the man is the head of the family. You look at the head. Head carries the brain. Head carries the mouth. Head carries the nose. Head carries the ears. Head carries, it's every part. You can do without a hand. You can do without legs. But you can't do without a head. Why? Because the head is a very vital part of the body. And that's why we need to empower the boy child. The boy child has been alienated. If we kick the boy child, if we deny the boy child opportunities, and we keep on lifting up the girl child, then things are not going to be good in the future, because the boy child will end up with lesser opportunities. And even in their home, they feel lesser, because if they are not celebrated, if they are not appreciated, and they are made to feel like now we are more on the girl, we are more on the feminine, then it's somehow not the God's way of doing creation. And so the Bible says in Ephesians chapter number 25, and I love it. I love just how the Bible says that husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself up for it. Jesus gave himself up for the church. Now the man, who is the husband, is expected to give himself up for her, for his wife. I've seen men give themselves up for their businesses. I've seen men give themselves up for the dreams they carry. How many men today can be counted that they have given their lives up for their wives? And then the husband, the Bible continues to say that he might sanctify it, having cleansed it by the washing of water with the word, that he might present the church to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. Husband are charged here. Watch the words you give your wife. Watch the words you speak to your wife. Watch the words. You can call her names and expect this. When you call her, the names you call her are the names you are making her. You see, the Bible says by the using of the words, you are washing her, you are cleansing her, and you are making her fit for your use. I've had men, even in sittings where there are no women, and they talk negative about their wives. Now, if you talk negative to your wife, you are creating something that will come back to you. You are creating something that will not be useful to you. But when you appreciate her, when you appreciate her cooking, when you appreciate her dressing, when you appreciate her smile, even if she has lost her teeth, when you appreciate her figure, even though she has lost her figure giving birth to your children, appreciate her. You will be a king in her life, and she's going to give you back that which you want her. So you wash her with your words, not watching her with your words. Wash her with your words. Now when you wash her, you make something that is desirable, not just for you, but even for your children and for others. You see, we are in a culture as Africans, and I'm a bit skeptical about it, where men were not taught to express love. They were not taught how to express it, because even when their parents were walking even to church, going to the same destination, the mama would be left behind, closing the doors, closing the gates, going back to see if the firewood is okay, and then the man would say, we'll meet where we are going. Even walking together was not seen. Now even sitting together was something else. You could even see in the churches, you could see in every kind of a setting, there is a column for men, there is a column for women. You wouldn't even know who is married to who. Even using the wife, this is the mother of my children, this is the mother of my house, this is the one I live with. Difficult to say this is my sweetheart. Why? Because of how people grew up. People are not, they didn't grow to express love. They didn't grow to show the love. Even today, There is a woman who be told by their husband, I love you, and they begin to laugh. Like, that is something strange they've heard. They are not used to hearing it. Because there are things that we grew up, and it's time as the church, it's time as the people that are living today, let's now bring the love in our homes. Let's teach our children, it's okay to love your wife. Why are they doing things in their secret? Because they don't see them in the confines of their family. It's hard to see husband and wife playing in their home. If there is any kind of playing, it's not, in fact, even the husband might start playing and the wife begin to say, stop that, the children are watching. It should not be the case. We should be able to teach them. We should be able to grow and to glow in love, because love allows people to grow. And he says to present him, to present the church without spot, without wrinkle or any such thing. When you look at your wife, when you look at the woman that you've wooed and she's now your wife, you should be able to present her to yourself as blameless, as spotless, as wrinkleless. Don't just point out the flaws. Don't point out the things that are not working. Don't point out the things that are not fit. I remember just the other day, one of my friends told me something and it just made me happy. He said, the wife told him in the morning, have you ever seen a young man who is 50 years old? That was, in other words, she was telling the husband, now years are catching up, stop acting like a young person. Begin to work like an old man now. But I think that we should be forever young. Now, coming back now to these spots of love, any relationship goes through stages. When people begin together, you can see people eat, they will share food. Some will even pull food from the other's mouth and put it in their mouth. That is the initial stages. They can share towels, they can share everything, even one plate. They say, don't bring two plates, we can use one plate. Then when they now get into the other stage now of discovery, just like kids grow and then they begin out, they want to discover, they want to explore. Someone wants to have their own plate, someone wants to have their own space. Stop using this, stop using my thing. This is now my towel, this is now my toothbrush. Initially, they would share even a toothbrush, just like kids. But then when as it advances with age, then people want their own space, they want their freedom. Now, when a relationship now gets into the teenage stage, that's when people now begin to come out in true colors. That's when you hear someone who used to call the other sweetheart is beginning to wonder, where did I meet them? What was I thinking? It's not like the other person. But it's an age or a stage that comes in a relationship. Then when it gets to maturity now, is when people now settle down and they're like, wow, I'm glad I settled for this one. Most marriages or most relationships break when it's in their teenage. If people don't understand now, it's time for us to slow down. It's time for us to begin to work together and work out together and do more things together, because that is the stage that most people lose it. Now, as we celebrate Valentine this year, we would want to do many things. How many today are thinking about their spouses? How many today are thinking about their husband? How many today are thinking about their wife? How many today are thinking about that special person that cares to them? Is it just a day for just people who love one another? Or can it be extended to parents? Can you extend it to your children? Can you extend it to colleagues? Can you extend it? Now, this is the point. If you are willing to celebrate other people on Valentine, let your number one celebration be the person that you wake up next to. Let your number one celebration be the person you sleep next to. Let your number one celebration be the person that you are determined to spend your years with for the glory of God. Now, the Bible continues to say that even so ought husbands also to love their own wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his own wife loveth himself. If you love your body, then it should be shown by how you love your wife. You cannot say you love your wife and you cannot say you love yourself if you don't love your wife. Because the Bible said the two shall become one. How do you love your wife? I know people who have never even bought a skirt for their wife. They have never even bought, they can't even tell you the size. They can't tell you what they say, hey, that one, I don't even understand her taste. Why don't you understand? Because at some point in life, you grew apart. You didn't grow together. We need to grow together. We need to be able to understand. If I bring her this, she'll appreciate, because I am not just a man in her house. I am the man in her heart. I am the man in her life. And I understand her more than anybody else understands. The Bible also continues to say, for no man ever hated his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth it, even as Christ also the church. When you love yourself, You will see a man go to a nyama choma joint and get 2 kilos of meat. You think he's taking to the family. And he will devour all of it. Like, ta-ta-ta, everything is gone. And he will say, well, I didn't see how it went. Bring me the intestines, the matumbos, eh? Those are sides. And then he will eat and begin to say, wow, that food was good. Now you can wrap some so that I can go eating along the way. Now, you love, well, if you love yourself too much and you don't express it on your wife, there is a problem. There is a mistake. And so we need to understand that we need to cherish our wife. We need to nourish them, not just with words, but even physically. The Bible also continues to say, because we are members of his body. For this cause shall a man leave his wife, I mean his father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Wow, that is now another thing. According to our African culture, it is the wife that leaves to come and cleave to the husband's side. Now, the man says, I have brought another daughter to my father. I have brought another daughter to our family. It's like the woman is the only one that lives. But the Bible is talking about the man leaving to come and cleave. You cannot cleave before you leave. Now, the relationship is not a family thing first. Because the Bible says when God saw Adam, for Adam it was not fit for him to be alone, he created him a helper. He did not create him a whole village. He did not create him the in-laws. He created him a helper. Why? Because family is for two. If you allow other people to infiltrate your relationship, some people hear a lot of gossip. That's why you need to be careful how you speak to your wife. Because women, words break them or make them. That's why women are so prone and they are so vulnerable when it comes to gossip. Because words, they kill. Words, they bear a lot. And it can really put them down. The Bible says, please, for this cause shall a man, not even the woman, but a man shall leave to cleave to the wife. And the two shall become one flesh. Now, verse 33. Nevertheless, do ye also severally love each one his own wife, even as himself. And let the wife see that she fear her husband. Now, when you look at it, the Bible is telling us even to fear the husband. Not fear as in when he comes home, you run for cover. Not that you cannot talk to him. By the way, you don't talk at your husband. You don't talk at his ideas. You need to talk to him. You need to address him. Don't just talk to. When you talk to someone, it shows that there is a disconnect. There is a discord. But when you talk when you talk to, there is communication. You are expressing yourself. You are expressing your idea. You are expressing that which God has ordained for us, because God doesn't even, most of the time, he will not be speaking at man. He will be speaking to a man. And God's perfect image of love is a love of forgiveness, a love that forgives and doesn't keep records, a love that is long-bearing, a love that is not full of jealousy. You know, there are relationships where there's too much jealousy until there's insecurity. You don't want to keep on calling somebody and finding out, who are you eating with? Where are you now? Stand where you are. I want to confirm where that's true. No, you want to give them their freedom. You want to give them the ability to become. Even as you grow together, as you bond together, you want to become. Now, how can a single person celebrate Valentine? Does it mean that you cannot celebrate when you're single? There are people who are widows. They once had their husbands. Today they don't have someone. There are people who had wives, but today they don't have a wife. There are people who have never been asked. They are still single. How can they celebrate Valentine? I said as I started that it's okay for you to love yourself. It's okay for you to shower because God has loved you. It is not a time for you to feel sad. In fact, there is this saying that goes, most married people, when they get married, before they are married, when they are single, they see every person who is married as very happy. They see every couple that is very happy. And then when they get married, they now begin to see every single person as being very happy. Now, enjoy your single moment. Enjoy your time of being alone, but not lonely. Enjoy that time. Take yourself out for dinner. Buy yourself a rose. It's okay. No one will take you to court for that. Just enjoy the moment as you prepare for the day God is bringing you your best person to celebrate with you, for not just for a night. And those people who keep on celebrating with people who are not their wives, they are not their husbands, it's a one hit, it's a hit and run kind of a thing. Watch out what spirit you are carrying into your future and even into your family. We need to be careful. It's not a night for you to just enjoy without the limits. It's not a night for you to enjoy without knowing, where am I heading? What am I doing? What am I creating? So that tomorrow you don't end up shedding tears that would have been avoided even today. So as we celebrate Valentine this year, celebrate it in the, it doesn't have to be expensive. It doesn't have to be something that you cannot really afford. You can make your Valentine just the way you want. You can make your own card. You can make your own gift. You can do something. You can make a special meal for that special person. You can do something just different, just to make them feel they're appreciated. And then after Valentine, make sure it's not something that stops. Keep it going. Keep it alive for the glory of God. And I believe that even the marriages that were not working, even as you deliberate on making the other person happy, God will reward your effort, because God always look at it. And make sure that in your relationship, you are not the person on set. You are not the person who is just waiting to receive. Most people are there just to receive, like the Dead Sea. Just there to receive, no return, nothing to give out, nothing to show appreciation. It's a time not just to receive. Don't be mad someone did not bring you anything. My question is, if they didn't bring you anything, did you take them anything yourself? Be the one who initiates. Be the one who keeps the ball rolling. And I believe that there is nothing that God does not reward, especially when it's done in good faith. So this time, this year, this season, be the person that celebrates your person. When you tell me that you love me, I want to make you see just what I want. Show you the loneliness and what it does. You walked into my life.
I'm Richard Chege for Blossom Boomers. Welcome to our products. Welcome.
I'm Rhoda Chege, event director at Blossom Boomers Limited. We are located along Kenyatta Avenue, Baraka Plaza, basement 25. Blossom Boomers deal with events, and this Valentine will be painting the whole town red by our services. Valentine involve as Blossom Boomers as a company, reason being we interact with couples who are in love and want to take their love in the next level. We sell fresh flowers, we sell gifts that you can give. Valentine is all about love. Love between a spouse, love between parents and the children, loves even among his friends. And this is a setup for those who are married, for a family. You can do a backyard setup. When you think Valentine, it's a matter of the heart. And that is why we have this walkway sign saying that when you're thinking about the Valentine, this Valentine, let your heart give an explanation by giving a gift. And that is why we set up this walkway to express that is a matter, love is a matter of your heart. Yes. We always theme, like now this Valentine, we're gonna theme everything red, including our walkway. This is not dress. This is something we bled for deco, because we want that red. We will paint the town red, starting with our walkway. And this you can only find it at Blossom Boomers. As I had said earlier, that is only where you find unique stuff to express, to show the gesture of love. Yeah. These you can set up for your family. You make a special meal. You can even get a chef with a very minimal amount of money for that for this Valentine, just to set up a dinner for you. It is affordable. You can do such a setup. And you can also call us to do such a setup for your family. And this Valentine will also be selling fresh flowers. You can buy a single rose as a little as a, about Kenya shillings, 50 shillings. You can also buy, there are those couple that want to keep the flowers for a long time. So we've also made that arrangement. You can have such a rose, a beautiful rose, and the one receiving can keep it for a longer time. We can also do some chocolate eclairs in a basket. And this is simple, it's affordable, so that everybody can be able to buy something that particular, this Valentine, and take it home with them. When it comes to colors, we have the colors that shows, like red, it's love, white, it's peace, calmness. And this time, we've come up with something even that even a believer can also be able to buy. If you don't buy a rose for some reason, you can buy a perfume, and a nice perfume. You can buy from us. This is coffee. The person you're giving will appreciate. And we decided this time to also have as alcohol free, zero alcohol, doesn't have any alcohol. The ingredients are grape juice, fruit essence, carbon dioxide, citric acid. You can get this from us. This is not the time for us believers to go drinking, to go trying this, but this is just cut out for us. It's just grapes that are, and I believe you will enjoy it. It tastes very nice. You will enjoy, and you don't have to go and drink like the three people are doing. We should be setting a good example this Valentine. On top of that, you may want on this Valentine to be a blessing and to just to express love to your parents. You can get them even juice. We package them nicely in a hamper and we deliver. You can do several fresh flowers. You can even do a bouquet. And for our products, you can give a parent, you can give your wife, you can give your husband, you can give your children.
All the things we ever wanted were once yours and mine. day, I gave your love away. We can't survive it, all the pain we feel inside. You relied on me, now I've let you down.
Cheers. So as we said, Valentine is about love. This Valentine, ensure you've taken care of the person that you love, the person that you see every morning,
yes.
The person that you, when you wake up, when you sleep, you see them. Mm-hmm. Just as I'm doing, taking care of the person that I always see every morning.
Wow.
Oh, yes.
The person that when I wake up, when I go to bed, I see him. And the best friend, he's my best friend,
yes.
The person that has made Blossom Boomers be a successful.
Yes.
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 Reciprocate. Love is reciprocated.
And as I look into your eyes, I see an angel in disguise, sent from God above for me to love, to hold and idolize. And as I hold your body near, I see this month through to a year, and then forever on till life is gone, I'll keep your loving strength to carry.